I have some amazing news to share with you. Another Indian youngster, Raunak Sadhwani, who's born in 2005 and is still 15 years old, has become 2600 rated. Raunak achieved this feat at the age of 15 years, 8 months, and 7 days, which is truly phenomenal. And just to show you what he managed to achieve in the last few days is the following. I want to pull up this here. Look at this. These are the tournaments that he has played, and it started from 11th of June and has reached on 29th of August. So he has played like 79 days of chess, and he's played 70 games, 8 tournaments. It's simply phenomenal. He started with the closed round robin in Serbia, gained 0.4 points there. Then Silver Lake, he did very well. He finished second behind Nihal Sarin. He got 12.5 Elo points. Serbia Open was bad. He lost 12 Elo points. Sorry, it was also in Serbia, not in Latvia. Then it was Saint White Open in Austria, where he gained 12 Elo points. Portuguese League in Portugal, where he gained 11 Elo points. Then BL Masters. And you can see that every tournament was back to back. There was hardly any space in between. Like the Portuguese League ended on 25th, BL Masters 20 started on 26th. Then BL Master ends, then he went to Italy to play in the Spilimbergo Open, where he gained 10 Elo points, and Innsbruck Open, where he again gained 10 Elo points. These last two tournaments, Spilimbergo and Innsbruck, he won both these tournaments. So from a rating of 2555, he has now reached a rating of 2602, which is tremendous and a great achievement. Here are a few of his pictures from Innsbruck Open, the latest tournament that he won. That's Raunak over there, and with his proud mother, Hina, he's standing here, and also the prize ceremony over here. Raunak, this is his performance at the Spilimbergo Open, where he scored 7 points, performed at 2665, and this is his performance at the Innsbruck Open, where again he performed at 2692, and in both the tournaments he did not lose a single game. So that is something truly phenomenal. And I want to also show you, I like this, and maybe you might also enjoy, as to how much you have to travel. Like for example, he traveled from Serbia, from India, Nagpur, where he lives, to this place in Serbia, Vrhči. Then he went from here to Silver Lake Open, which is here. Then he went to Belgrade. So these three tournaments were quite close to each other. Then he traveled to Austria over here. That's a little bit far away. If this is Serbia here, he had to travel a bit to reach Austria. From Austria, he had to travel all the way here to Portugal to play the league in Portuguese league. From there, he traveled to Switzerland to play in the BL Masters over here. From BL, he went to Spilimbergo, which is somewhere here in Italy. And from Italy, he traveled to Austria here, to Innsbruck. So all the travel that he did was not for nothing. He performed brilliantly at all these events, and he gained so many Elo points. Let's have a look at couple of his games from the last tournament, the Innsbruck Open, where I think his play is kind of, you can just understand the kind of player Raunak is. I want to show two games. In fact, there were many games, but he's so aggressive. He likes to calculate. He likes to play sharp. That's his style of play. So let's have a look at this seventh round. Raunak is playing with Lech Lucas over here, who is 24-01, and Raunak has white pieces. He opens the game with 1e4, c5, knight f3, d6, knight c3, knight f6, takes, takes, knight to c6. This is the classical variation, and now the Richter Rouser with bishop g5, e6. Here, main move is queen d2, but Raunak goes for the topical line with bishop b5. We also saw recently Balazs Csonka playing this with Arjun Erigesi. Bishop d7, queen d3, queen b6, long castle. And I think here black could have gone for this simplifications with take, take, take. And I think it's roundabout even, maybe very slightly better for white, but it's a playable position. Instead, he went bishop e7, and now Raunak took on c6, bishop takes, f4, black went rook d8. So black was a little bit afraid of e5 move. That's why he put his rook here to put pressure down the d file. But in fact, castle was okay. You can't really go e5 just as yet, because after knight d5, you are protecting the bishop. And if you take on d5, bishop takes g5 comes with a check. So that wins for black. But rook d8, Raunak brought his rook into the game. H6. I think castling was still possible, but black was trying to play a little bit more creatively. He went h6, bishop h4, and g5. Ooh, this is a little bit dangerous. Now Raunak put his bishop on g3. The point here is that if you take fg5, he wants to go knight g4, and you can't take here because the bishop will hang. It's a typical motif in the Sicilian that you are fighting for the e5 square. Bishop g3, knight to g4. And now, a good move here would have been queen f3, attacking the knight. And after gf4, bishop f4, knight e5. Here is a key idea. What should white play? Try to think. Try to figure out what is the best move. Your queen is attacked. Yes, well done if you found takes, takes, and boom. Takes and queen h5. This is over. Rook f1 check. King is not surviving this. It's getting checkmated. But Raunak, instead of going queen f3, which was maybe the best, he played another daring move. And I think it's totally in the spirit of the position, because the black king is in the center. And this is what shows Raunak's playing style. You know, it's aggressive. It's direct. He just goes for it. Knight d5. Black took. Raunak took back. And now look at this. This is opened up. Okay, you can go bishop d7 as well. But then after h3, the knight is slightly misplaced. Knight has to go back. Fg, hg, queen e3, now threatening a mate here. Knight d5, queen e4, bishop c6, knight takes, pawn takes, and rook d5. Just an illustrative line to show you how black is still in trouble. So black took the pawn on d5. And now Raunak played a nice move here. Maybe you can think about it, what to do here as white. Yeah, two moves win here. One of them is queen f5, which is very strong. It kind of traps the knight on g4, because important to note that here knight f6 is met with queen f6. There's also another move which Raunak played, queen e2, which is winning because it's a double attack here and here. The other idea is also knight f5 in this position, but bishop e6, black can still fight on here. Queen e2 was nice, rook d7, and now he chopped off the knight. And just like that, he has a winning position, because now the number of pieces are equal. But Raunak, the thing about him is that he finishes off in the most precise manner. White to play, what do you do here? Boom. That's what, there are many boom moments in this game. If king e7, there is queen g5. Oops. And then this is hanging. So rook e7. And now knight f5. Rook e4. Queen g5 check. King d7. And rook takes d5. Rook e6. And now, guys, finish off the game. What do you do? Boom. Rook takes d6. Nice move. If rook takes d6, queen e7 is all over. So Raunak won this game, very nice one, you have to agree. And then he played once again in the last round. There was one more game. Sorry, this is not the last round. Last round was also very aggressive, but this is the fifth round. So I showed you the seventh round game of his. And now let's look at the fifth round game. This is against Loeffler Marcus. And Raunak is white here. Loeffler Marcus is 2295. So Raunak is clearly superior, but rating wise. But let's have a look at the game. This time against Sicilian, it was a6. Raunak is white, Loeffler is black. knight of h3, e5, knight b3. So h3 variation in the knight off, he goes g4, 6, bishop e3, knight bd7, a4, stopping b5 plans, queen c7, a5, fixing that, and now b5. Actually, this position has been reached in the game of Nepo and Carlsen. And Carlsen had gone for knight f8, knight g6 plan and had won it. Queen c7, a5, b5. This is also fine. Black seems to be doing well. He took here, queen takes, check to the king. You can't take because the rook is hanging on a8. So king f8, bishop c4, and now bishop b7, queen d3. So after g6, black wants to put his king here, and I think Raunak could have played castles is one way to play here. Although the king looks slightly unsafe, but it should be fine. The other idea was knight a5, and I think even here he's slightly better. But look at his creative play. Yeah, he goes rook f1. Maybe not the best move, but he's clearly angling at the king. He wants to open it up with f4. So black goes king g7, now f4. Takes, rook takes. Okay. Rook hf8 or rook hc8, all these moves were better, but black went d5. So black is following the very simple principle that if opponent's king is in the center, try to open up the position. Okay, Raunak said, fine, you want to open it, I don't mind, thank you for the pawn, I'm happy. And now, here, had to be slightly careful and play knight d7, and then maybe aim at knight e5 moves, put the bishop here or here, and okay, the position goes on, it's interesting. But bd6 was a mistake, and now the ball is in your court, guys. What do you play here as white? White to move, remember, I don't want to tell you what to remember. Come on, you can find it. White to move. What to do? Well, of course, boom. Rook takes f6. And now notice, if you take here, knight e4 check, king g7 trying to run away is met with queen c3 check. King here, knight f6. Game over. I mean, some deadly discovered check is going to come in and you lose the queen. If you go king e7, instead in this position, then black goes, white goes long castle. Remember, the king has not moved yet, not the rook, so long castle is possible, and once again the king is extremely weak on e7. So rook h8 check was played, the rook cannot be taken, and now Raunak played the move knight e4. Notice that anytime you give a check on g1, I can always come back to f1. So rook e4. And now he played queen e4. See, if you now take king f6, then after long castle, black is again in big trouble. The king is too exposed. And if you try to run away, then I can play rook f1. If you count the pawns, white is a pawn up and is winning. So he gave a check and he said, look, I'm going to keep your king in the center. King e2. And now he took with the queen. But Raunak's last move was very cool, king e2, because now he could get his rook into the game. So he took queen b2. Was a mistake. He should have gone queen d6 here. When the game still goes on, white is better after knight a5. But the game still, there's still a lot to play for. He went queen to b, takes b2. And now, what's your move here, white to play? You know the move. Boom. Rook takes f7. If you take here, d6, king f8, queen e7 is mate, king f6, also queen e7 is mate, so you go king g7, but then I take here, and you're already piece up, game over. So after rook takes f7 in this position, takes and d6, Loeffler resigned. These are the kinds of games which make you realize what a big talent this youngster is, Raunak. He has reached 2600 already, and he joins first, you know, Nihal had achieved it, then Prague at a very young age, both of them at the age of 14, then recently Arjun managed to reach there at age of 16, then Gukesh did it at age of 15 years and 2 months, and now Raunak has done it at the age of 15 years 8 months. So you know, like, all these Indian youngsters moving together towards the top already all of them in 2600. Raunak mentioned that there are a few people he would like to thank. Of course, his parents have played a big role. His mom has been traveling with him. His dad, of course, supporting him as well from home. But Microsense has been his sponsor, has been supporting him for a long time. Also, Westbridge Anand Chess Academy, where Vishy Anand and his team of trainers, Yusupov, Chanda and Gaevsky, working together with these youngsters has made a huge impact. And last but not the least, he also would like to thank Surya Ganguly, who has played a big role in his success. So, Raunak, well, we hope to have him soon on stream and maybe discuss a few more games. But from these two games, I think you get a style, you get an idea of his playing style. This is Sagar Shah signing off. I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye-bye.